Welcome, students. Now we're going to talk about future time clauses and models. Regarding future time clauses, we must remember that there are several ways to talk about the future. You can use be going to, will, the present progressive, or the simple present. If you, when you use will, okay, you can use will to make predictions or guesses about the future. For example, I think I will watch a movie tomorrow. When you use going to, okay, you can use going to talk about future intentions or plans. Okay, you can see in this timeline, for example, I'm going to watch a movie tomorrow. In this case, the action of watching a movie is in the future. Okay, you can see past, now, and the action of watching a movie is in the future. In this case, when I'm using going to in this sentence, I'm talking about a future plan. Okay, it means that I am almost 100% sure that I'm going to watch a movie tomorrow. Okay, now about the clauses. A sentence about the future can have two clauses. Okay, the verb in the main clause is often in the future. Okay, so we can use in this case will or be going to. We have an example here. He will look for a job when he graduates. Okay, so in this case we are joining two clauses. Okay, the main clause, he will look for a job. Okay, in this case it's called the main clause or the independent clause, and the time clause, when he graduates. Okay, in this case it starts with when, that indicates time, and it is a dependent clause. Okay, so we have the independent clause, he will look for a job, and the dependent clause, when he graduates. Okay, also called main clause and time clause. Okay, so you can see the independent clause or the main clause is in this clause I am using will, no? He will look for a job. In the second clause with the when, okay, the dependent clause or time clause, I am using the present, okay, the present tense, the simple present tense. Yeah, so you can see the verb in the time clause is often in the simple present. It can come at the beginning or at the end of the sentence. So you can say when he graduates he will look for a job, or you can say he will look for a job when he graduates. Okay, what is the difference? The difference is that in the first one I don't use a comma. Okay, when I start with the independent clause I don't use a comma, but if I start the sentence with the time clause I need to use a comma. When he graduates, comma, he will look for a job. Okay, you can see when he graduates, the time clause, he will look for a job, the main clause. Okay, so you can see that you have to use a comma after the time clause when it comes at the beginning. Okay, and don't use a comma when it comes at the end. You can see the difference here. Okay, it's the same sentence with the same meaning, but the difference is the comma and the order of the clauses. Okay, now something about models and similar expressions. The models can, could, may, should, ought, would, and will can be used to express ability, permission, request, advice, and suggestions. Okay, there are also other expressions that can be used. For example, be able to, do you mind if, had better, how about, why don't. Okay, so the use, you can see that the use is varied. Okay, there are a variety of uses, and for an example we are going to focus on one use, permission. Yeah, for permission you can use the models can, could, may, do you mind if, Okay, this is an expression, no? Do you mind if? You can use the modals can, could, and may to ask permission. For example, you say, could I borrow your book? Okay, in this case, you are asking for a book. When you use could for permission, it is not the past. Okay, in this case, could, I'm not using could to refer to the past. I am using could for permission, okay, to ask for a book. Another expression, may I go to the bathroom, please? Okay, I am asking for permission to go to the bathroom. Okay, so in this case, may is more formal than can and could. Okay, you can see that could is formal, but may is even more formal. Okay, so you can see that may is más formal que could in este caso. You can use can or may in answers. Okay, don't use could in answers. Could can be used when you ask a question. For example, in this case, could I please use your cell phone? Okay, this is I am asking for your cell phone. Okay. Yeah, the possible answers can be like this. One possible answer. Yes, of course you can. Okay, so you can see that I am using can in this case in the answer. Okay, I'm not using could. I'm using can. Another possible answer. Sure. Could I please use your phone, your cell phone? Sure. Okay, so in this case, in conversation, you can respond using sure, or you can use certainly, or you can use go ahead. Okay, this is another kind of response. Yeah, or another option for the response is, I'm sorry, but I need it. Okay, so in the two first responses, you can see that the person is given permission to the other person for using their cell phone, okay? But in the last response, the person is not given permission, okay? The person says, I'm sorry, but I need it. Okay, in this case, the person is refusing permission, okay? So you can see, in this case, examples of how to answer a question, okay? Whether given permission or not given permission. Okay, now we're going to talk about the expression, do you mind if, to ask permission. Okay, in this case, we use do you mind if to ask permission when your action may annoy or inconvenience someone. So you can see that this is also a formal expression to ask for something. In this case, in this example, we can say, do you mind if I take this pencil? Okay. In Spanish, it would be like, ¿te molestaría si tomo este lápiz? No? Okay, possible answers. Not at all. Or no, I don't. Okay. When you respond with not at all or not I don't, it means that it's okay, okay, that the person can take the pencil. But if you answer like this, if you answer, yes, I do, it means that you are not giving permission to this person, okay? Entonces, lo que ustedes pueden ver es que si yo respondo not at all o not, I don't, significa que yo le estoy dando permiso a la persona para que tome el lápiz, ¿no? Pero si respondo, yes, I do, significa que no estoy dando permiso. Okay, esa es la particularidad con respecto a preguntas con do you mind y las respuestas. Okay, okay, I think that's all about this topic. Thank you.